When a massive disaster hits a Gotham city still reeling from crisis, it'll take the Dark Knight and the Man of Steel to set things straight. All this and more in the pages of Batman Superman issue number 9. Let's hop on in together and find out what happens next, shall we? So then, as we join the book, the Gotham cops have dragged the river and pulled up a corpse. Now, obviously, that's not strange for Gotham City. Dead bodies wash up on the shore all the time, but this one is different. It's got a bunch of weird mechanical enhancements. But more on this in a minute. From there, we transition on over to Batman, who's patrolling the city in the Batmobile, that one particular Batmobile with the big face on it, you know the one I'm talking about. In Batman's eternal monologue, he talks about how the city is trying to get back on its feet following the City of Bane incident, which is pretty damn interesting because this is maybe the only other book I can think of outside Tom King's Batman that actually makes reference to that story, so good on you, Williamson, for trying to keep continuity alive. Batman quickly gets alerted to trouble that's happening downtown. It seems that Superman foe Atomic Skull has come to Gotham and is now running amok. Granted, if you've been reading Superman comics in the last decade, you'll know that this is strange. As Atomic Skull had actually reformed his wicked ways and become something of a good guy, so him here now causing destruction is out of character for him. Batman manages to make the scene just in enough time to see Atomic Skull blasting a bunch of SWAT guys. Naturally, the Dark Knight, being the suspicious fellow that he is, assumes that Skull is broken bad once again. But to hear Skull tell it, that's not the case at all. He wasn't rampaging, he was running from something, some mystery foe who tried to mess with his head, which, you know, is pretty dangerous considering this guy is a walking, talking nuke. It's also here, too, Batman starts to put together that there's something odd about these SWAT guys. For one, they smell like absolute death, and for second, all of their gear is out of date. One swift bat roundhouse kick to the face later, and we realize that these SWAT guys actually have a lot of the same robotic implants that the dead guy who washed up on the shore had. It would seem these SWAT dudes aren't people at all, but mind-controlled drones for some bigger, nastier evil that had plans for Atomic Skull. And it seems whatever this mystery villain did to Atomic Skull, it's taken its toll. He can't contain his nuclear power anymore and apologizes to Batman before going nuclear all over Gotham. Naturally, destruction on this level eventually reaches the ears of Superman, who is in Paris right now trying to have a quiet date with his wife, which is proving to be quite impossible after Superman outed his own secret identity over in the Bendis book. Clark says out of respect to Batman, he always tries to give Gotham and what's going on there a wide berth, but right now it cannot be denied that the city most certainly needs him, and as such, Superman gets there fast as a speeding bullet to help rescuing people. Using his super senses, Superman is able to riddle out that this explosion isn't the normal type of nuking you might consider. For one, even though everything is bathed in radiation, it's not the toxic, deadly kind. Secondly, all the buildings that were destroyed were empty anyway following the City of Bane, which means no one really got hurt. Well, except for Batman, who got pinned under a car, but that's nothing Superman can't help with. Batman tells Superman that there's clearly something foul afoot, and that before he blew up, Atomic Skull said that whoever's pulling the strings in this situation has it out for Superman, and we end up finding out who that is in just a few moments. You see, those two beat cops from the beginning of the comic follow the trail that the dead body had left behind them and end up stumbling upon a man-made cave where they get jumped by, get this, the Ultra-freaking-humanite. Professional mad scientist, body hopper, and gorilla aficionado who has come all the way to Gotham City to enact his greatest evil scheme to date. You see, Atomic Skull was always a problem on his own, but the Ultra-humanite figures that he hadn't really tapped his true potential yet, and that he's going to kill Superman with a brand new atomic army as the comic comes to a close. And so that was Batman Superman issue number 9, everybody, and I gotta say, Joshua Williamson kicks off a pretty interesting new story arc. I love getting to see lesser-used villains like the Ultra-Humanite and Atomic Skull come back and actually be a big deal. I might not have enjoyed City of Bane as a story, but I certainly enjoy getting to see the actual continuity threads referenced and brought up again. It's also fun to see Batman have to challenge his distrusting nature. Then you got the artwork from Henry, who I gotta say turns in some really stellar pages here. I love his version of the Ultra-Humanite with all the little buckles and mechanical parts hanging out of him. It's good stuff. Overall, I'd give this one an 8 out of 10. Real nice read, and it's so fun to read new comics again, isn't it?
Hey there everyone, Cape Jewel again, and I want to thank you so much for watching to the end of the video. As always, if you liked what you see, be sure to like, subscribe, comment. It really helps drive engagement and helps me out too. Also, if you are a patron, which you can become for as little as a dollar a month, you will get exclusive content that no one else can ever see, and you'll get to see the Comic Multiverse podcast before anyone else too. You can check out all this and more down in the description. And until next time everyone, this has been Cape Jewel, and I'll see you all next time. Cheers.